Dear friends and flight students, welcome back to this third and last video of the holding pattern series. Today I'll be explaining you how to fly the entries as discussed in the previous video and how to correct for time and wind by using a pen and paper and a stopwatch. So get out your pen and stopwatch and let's get started. Let's discuss the wind and time corrections first and talk about how to fly the entries at the end. So you've established yourself in the holding, and as mentioned in the previous video, the inbound leg towards the holding fix shall always be 1 minute long below flight level 140 unless otherwise specified by ATC. But your stopwatch is showing different. Your inbound leg is 1 minute and 30 seconds long, and at the same time, you are nowhere near the inbound course when coming out of the outbound turn. Now, the only reason for that is, yes, wind. So in order to counteract from being pushed off your desired track, you need to calculate a so-called WCA, a wind correction angle. During your flight briefing, you had a look at the weather forecast, and the winds near your destination airport are blowing from the northwest with 330 degrees at 20 knots. So as you fly 100 knots with your Cessna and want to navigate directly towards the holding fix at a track of 360, as you are on a radial 180 inbound, the wind blows with a 30 degree angle at you. So the formula to use is wind angle times wind speed divided by true airspeed gives you the wind correction angle you have to add or subtract to your heading in order to fly the desired track towards the VOR. So instead of flying heading 360 towards the VOR, you have to correct and fly a heading of 354. Makes sense, right? As the wind is coming from the left and wants to push you to the right, so you have to counteract the drift or push to fly into the wind. Now, another issue arises: you can't use the wind correction angle during a standard rate turn, meaning after you've passed the holding fix and you start your turn, the wind will continue to push as it also becomes a tailwind during the turn. So to counteract the drift, you have to apply the wind correction angle for the turn on the outbound course. Now, as the wind won't take a break during your flight along the outbound course, you have to add the wind correction a second time. Then you start to turn towards the inbound course, and now the wind actually becomes a headwind during your turn. So to compensate for the wind during the turn or the second turn, you add the wind correction a third time to your outbound heading. With our example, that would mean instead of flying heading 180, we add three times the wind correction angle. So 3 × 6 = 18 degrees. So we have to fly heading 198 into the wind. So memorize, if you are flying inbound to the fix, add the wind correction angle once, and then the outbound, 3 times wind correction angle. So for the first turn along the outbound course and for the second turn. Now, what about timing? Now, I could get really mathematical about the determining steady headwind and crosswind component, but there are simpler and quicker rules to apply for timing corrections. Now, as we look at this diagram here, we have our plane and a 180 degree arc, now which is divided into 4 pieces. Now, let's say we're flying on our outbound course, which is the determining one regarding wind correction and timing. Now, using our example, we have a wind blowing from 330 with 20 knots, so it's in the first quarter of our diagram. Now, regarding the wind, you can clearly see it's a tailwind, so you'll be flying faster down the outbound leg. So the rule applies: for each knot of tailwind, subtract 1 second of your outbound time. So in our case, that will be 20 seconds, leading to an outbound leg of 40 seconds, right? Now let's say the wind were to be blowing from 290 with 20 knots, and so it would be in this quarter. Now here, the wind is more of a crosswind with less tailwind effect. So for each knot of wind speed, subtract 0.5 seconds. So in our case, 20 times 0.5 seconds is 10 seconds of our minute equals an outbound timing of 50 seconds. Now let's say the wind is blowing from 1900 with 10 knots. Now the wind has become a headwind, slowing you down on your outbound leg. So instead of subtracting 10 seconds, you add 10 seconds, leading to an outbound leg of 1 minute and 10 seconds. Now because once you turn towards the fix, it then becomes a tailwind which will let you fly faster. Now and again, if the wind becomes more of a crosswind and less of a headwind effect, you multiply the wind speed times 0.5 seconds. So important to know, is the wind on the outbound leg a tailwind or a headwind and at which angle? To subtract or add seconds to your outbound time to end up at a 1 minute inbound leg. Now great advice of mine, practice, practice, practice. Ain't nothing to it but to do it. So a big question arises, when do you start the timing on the outbound leg? Now when you are a beam of the holding fix. How do you know when you're a beam of the station or the holding fix? When your OBS or HSI flicks from the to indication to the from indication. Similar technique applies on the NDB holdings. As soon as the ADF needle points at a 90 degree angle to your outbound course, you can start timing. And once you've completed your turn flying towards the fix, you start timing when your wings become level. Now let's talk about how to fly the holding entries. Because you have to apply wind correction angles to your entries, that's why I had to explain that first. You've determined that you have to enter the hold with a teardrop entry using the technique shown in the previous video. So I've placed the teardrop entry into our example holding. Now important to know, the first heading you need to fly is the inbound radial 180 minus 30 degrees, which gives us a heading of 150. But as you are going to turn towards the inbound course, you need to add your calculated wind correction angle. So in this case, plus 6, so heading 156 for 1 minute. Then you do your turn and apply the wind correction angle again for your inbound course. So teardrop entry, 30 degree angle plus or minus wind correction angle for 1 minute and another wind correction angle for the inbound course. Then the parallel entry. As shown here, you fly parallel to the inbound course in the opposite direction for 1 minute, then do a 250 degree turn so that you intercept your inbound course at a 45 degree angle. So how often do we need to apply the wind correction angle? One time for the parallel entry, one time for the turn, and one time to track down the inbound course. And last but not least, the direct entry, which is the easiest to fly. You cross the holding fix and you turn towards the outbound leg. And as you are more or less flying the normal holding pattern, you therefore apply the wind correction angle three times in the outbound leg as you would do in a normal holding pattern and once for the inbound course as usual. So how can you practice these techniques? Now, if you have a flight simulator on your computer, they are a great help to practice the wind correction angle and timing calculations. Or click the link in the description box below, which forwards you to a holding trainer app you can download from Amazon. But once you get the hang of it, it's a lot of fun and will give you more confidence once you're actually in the plane. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this three-part series about the holding patterns. Please comment below if you want to see more flight school related videos in the future. And don't forget, a good pilot is always learning. See you next week. All the best, your Captain Joe.